Hi Rushers, I'm Margaret Colin from Arcadia, and you are watching Stage Rush TV.
What's going on, Rushers? Welcome back to Stage Rush TV. So I know a lot of you guys are really loving the Broadway play Arcadia. It's a Tom Stoppard revival. It's a very dense play. Now, it was a little difficult to me understand, but I got some help from you guys explaining to me what it was about, which was pretty awesome to have that discussion with you guys. This week I sat down with Margaret Colin, who plays Lady Croom in Arcadia, and she's one of these actresses that we've seen for many, many years. I mean, she was Jeff Goldblum's girlfriend in the movie Independence Day, and currently she's one of the parents in Gossip Girl. She's Leighton Meester's mother, the character of Blair Waldorf. She plays Eleanor Waldorf, and she's this wonderfully, you know, witty and caustic character, and she's so good at these biting lines on Gossip Girl. And she's kind of the same as Lady Croom, and what she said in our interview was that she did, Eleanor Waldorf did inform her Lady Croom in this show, which is really fun. But so she's a very funny actress, but one thing that I thought was really interesting when talking with Margaret is that she's just as funny, but in a different kind of way. She's actually very goofy and silly, and she's kind of this big ball of cute joy, which I really enjoyed. She was a blast to talk with, and you can really see that in the interview and in the video segment that I put up. She's so funny. You know, she said that, like many, like me, for instance, when she first saw Arcadia back in 1995 when it was on Broadway, she said it was very difficult for her to understand, and she says that all she took away from it was the little turtle prop that's on the table in both eras of the play. She says, "I just remembered the turtle," which I thought was so funny. Another hilarious thing that really got me in our interview was that when we talked about her costumes, her 19th century costumes, which are very elegant in the show, I kind of was expecting, like, oh, I love these elegant costumes, they're so nice. And she couldn't stop repeating how much she hated the costumes. She was like, "I hate these costumes, they make me explode," but the word hate just kept coming out. It was so funny. And another thing you can see in our video segment, she just cracked me up, is that Margaret Colin says the phrase when she's discussing the kind of strenuous process that was her Independence Day movie audition. She said that she needed that strenuous process, like, I needed that kick in the tits, like a hole in the head. And I just think she's so funny when she says that.
And I needed that, like, kick in the tits, like a hole in the head, so.
Oh, she was really a riot. So one thing that I wanted to show you guys is that Margaret told this fantastic story about across from the from her dressing room window at the Barrymore Theater, is right across the alley is Harvey Fierstein's window from over at La Cage aux Folles, and that when they're not on stage, they talk to each other like teenage friends out the window. It's so funny. She gives a great Harvey Fierstein impression. Check that out.
Harvey, so Harvey and I play a balcony scene almost every day
because he's across
because
the street.
He calls from the alley. This is the window in my dressing room at the Helen Hayes at the Barrymore Theater, and so Harvey stands out in the alley, and this alley connects the Barrymore to the La Cage aux Folles Theater,
mm-hmm.
And so Harvey stands out there and goes, and I lift up the window, and there's Harvey with his wig prep on. So he's got a skull cap on, and he's in full drag. And he screams, "What are you doing? How are you?" And he takes out his chicken cutlet, and he throws it at me, and he puts it back in his dress. And we just, you know, sometimes we sing. We do a little West Side Story, and then he does his job, and I do mine.
It's so fantastic. It's very good. It's like, oh, that's great.
It's really great. And on the other side is Estelle Parsons and Fran McDormand, and I've worked with both of them, so I feel like I'm in the best possible block on Broadway for me at all.
That is exciting. Oh, cool. It reminds me of, like, in like the teen movies in the 80s with the tin cans or something, and they throw them across, and the girl and guy would talk like that.
Yes, indeed. Except it's Harvey screaming in drag.
Well, thank you so much to Margaret Colin. She's really hilarious. Please check out my Q&A with her on Stage Rush, and also go see Arcadia if you haven't done so already. So, what a crazy world Broadway is. Really, it's incredibly unpredictable, and that's kind of, you know, what we all love about it. The highs and the lows about it. And this week, I really am surprised. You know, High opened this week, and the day after its opening night, it announced that it is closing this Sunday. It'll have played just 8 regular performances and 28 previews. I know this show is having trouble selling tickets. I discussed that with Stephen Kunken in our interview that you can see on Stage Rush, which I discussed last week. And, you know, we discussed that the tickets prices were low, but there was still hope, and I thought that good reviews and word of mouth would boost sales to this play, because this is one of my favorite straight plays of the season. And it's closing now. What I was truly shocked when I found this out, I'm doing work on my screen, on my computer screen, and the headline comes across, and my jaw hit the floor. I really couldn't believe it. I was so shocked. Maybe others saw this coming, but I didn't. But then one of the first things that came to my mind was Stephen Kunken's luck is just outrageous. I mean, lucky in the sense that this guy gets cast in Broadway shows all the time. He's got a great Broadway career, but last season, he was in Enron, he got nominated for a Tony, and the day of his nomination, they announced the closing notice. It was so soon after that play had opened, and a year later, the same thing is happening with his play, High. You know, it's closing right after it opens. I just can't believe it. It's a really tough road to be an actor. We learned that here on Stage Rush, we learned that on Broadway. But, you know, the highs and the lows, I think, are what make us love Broadway. It's unpredictable, and we love it for that reason. So, you know, our best wishes to the cast and crew of High and to Stephen Kunken, especially, for talking with us last week. Moving on to some Broadway grosses, Jerusalem is selling pretty strong with 87% of its tickets. Lombardi, which was held strong in many, many weeks, the only surviving play from the fall, is slipping a bit. It sold 46% of its tickets last week. The Book of Mormon is an absolute smash, selling 102% of its tickets, and this is not certainly the first time it's done this. And how the House of Blue Leaves with Ben Stiller and Edie Falco is selling very, very strong, still in previews, selling 97% of its tickets. So I just wanted to say this is the 60th episode of Stage Rush TV, and I wanted to say thank you so much to everyone who watches every week. This couldn't be more of a blast. I hope you enjoy it too, and please keep coming back to watch. I absolutely love having this conversation with you guys. That's all for this week. Have a great week in the theater.